I want to talk about the Cavaliers. The Cavaliers got bitch slapped for two games. The Golden State Warriors totally took advantage of them. And I believe in karma. I think that statement in that press conference where one of them said that they were better than the LA Lakers.
Yeah, the Showtime Lakers from the early 80s. Yeah, he said
that. That's right. I think it came back to bite him in the ass.
Absolutely. How could you win by 33 points, Golden State, and then, you know, and then lose by 30 points, you know, three or two?
I'm just saying I believe in karma, and sometimes you can't toot your horn that loud, you get in an accident.
Yeah, so what happens now? They always say in sports, you know, you haven't lost the series until you lose one at home. Well, what if Cap, you know, that same thing with San Jose and the Stanley Cup playoffs, which we'll get to.
Yeah, but let's not get ahead of ourselves. We'll talk about Tacky in 4 minutes. I just wanted to, you know, Eric's a big basketball guy.
Let me tell you this.
Come back with that beating that they gave on the Warriors?
You know what? Here's the thing. We saw this, Frank, in the Toronto-Cleveland series, right? Cleveland destroyed Toronto at home, and then Toronto came back and won the next two at home.
But they never really destroyed the Cleveland.
No, they didn't.
Cleveland, I didn't know who the team they were playing, because the two games that the Warriors played against Cleveland where they were so dominant.
Yeah, you know, Frank, in professional sports, home court advantage in the NBA is more prevalent than it is with home ice, than home field. It's the biggest home road discrepancies come in the NBA.
Okay, but fair enough. So
and that's why you saw three different.
If Cleveland wins the next game, then all the guys. You see, this is what I fucking hate, Billy. Isn't it crazy? The Warriors win two games, and LeBron James is no longer a great player. Everything changes. Everybody just jumps ship like rats.
Oh yeah, well that's because of the level that King James operates at. He's the king of the game, and people like to downplay him. They like to make him look ordinary. They like to make him look like he's the problem in the dressing room. When this guy wants to play, he can outplay anybody.
My point is, you know, everybody who said that Cleveland was the best team and the greatest team and this and that, as soon as they lost those two games, everybody jumped ship like a fucking bitch.
Well, people jump on and off the bandwagon, Frank. Welcome to the world of sports. That's what happened.
Yeah, but I never did that because I always say it's not over till it's over.
Yeah, but you know what? Wouldn't you like, I mean, what was the first game? It ended, what? It was a whitewash.
The first two games, the Warriors crushed the Cavaliers.
Right, so the last game, last night, was...
Would that be a fair statement?
Yes,
that the Warriors
crushed
the Cavaliers the first two games?
What I'm saying is...
they blew them out the first two games at home.
And then 30 points last night for Cleveland. Wouldn't you like a series that's a little bit closer?
I'll tell you this, in the first two rounds with the Raptors? Right now on the record, game four in Cleveland will be a close game.
Thank you.
Well, I'm telling you this. I don't know if it's going to be a close game or a wide game. It's going to be mano a mano. I think LeBron James is very pissed off, and I agree with exactly what Billy said, that they always trying to make him be less of the great player that he is. He's probably one of the best players, if not the best player in the world. And, you know, my favorite player of all time was Jordan. And I think that LeBron James is just as good.
Yeah, but what I'm saying, look at the nail-biting that we went through during the first two rounds of the Toronto Raptors.
We had a vested interest in the Raptors.
Yeah, but I just want a good game out of the championship final.
You're going to get a good game, but you're going to see. Listen, you got the two best teams in the NBA on the court, and it's all about mojo and about energy. Let me ask you something, Bill. Isn't it weird you got your team, let's say when in 93 or 92 when the Leafs were at the top of their game, right? They were hot, they were great, and then they fucking play a mediocre team or a team that's good but not as good as them, and they get blown out. It happens, right?
Absolutely. And there's always an explanation post hoc. They weren't ready to play. They may or may not have been ready to play.
But it happens. It happens. Whether you're fucked up or the rhythm of the game, they just can't get it. Your goalie doesn't feel good. It happens. What I'm going to say is, before I say bye to Eric Cohen to bring back Phyllis Macedo on, is, you know, it's not over till it's over. Let's wait till the next game. If Cleveland comes back, and I'm not a fan either or, my team's gone. But I'm a fan of the game. So I agree with Johnny. Let's make it a competitive series so it'd be watchable, right?
You know how many people are tuning out worldwide when the game is over with 6-8 minutes to go and the Cavs or the Warriors are up by 35? Click, remote, gone.